And I'm very pleased to be here with Minister Chong, Ms. Blackwell, Mr. Young, Mr. McBride, and all of you to celebrate, indeed, a big step forward. Because I'm here to announce a critically important initiative that will protect the marine environment around Victoria and southern Vancouver Island for future generations. It's a project that will create local jobs, leverage private sector innovation, and contribute to the long-term health and well-being of Vancouver Islanders. You know, the ocean is indeed something that we're all very proud of as West Coasters. It's a valuable resource for recreation, for tourism, for the economy, and indeed to our quality of life. And we guard our oceans, and we want to keep them safe and clean. And keeping the marine environment and keeping it clean is indeed a key priority for all British Columbians and all Canadians and for our government. That's why I'm very pleased to be here today on behalf of Prime Minister Stephen Harper to announce over $253 million in federal funding for the construction of a regional wastewater treatment system here in the Capital Regional District. This is $250 million to stop and to end the dumping of sewage into the waters around Victoria. Today our government is delivering on a campaign commitment made by Prime Minister Harper before we took office. The CRD had presented this project as a priority for the region when I became regional minister for the province of British Columbia last year. When I came over here and met with stakeholders, this was again identified as the top priority for Victoria and for the CRD. And the Prime Minister recognized then, and we recognized last year, and it's why we are here today, to make sure that this project moves forward so that we do have a cleaner ocean and job creation here in Victoria and around the South Island. The new core area wastewater treatment program will consist of three projects: the McLaughlin Wastewater Treatment Plant and Marine Outfall, a biosolids energy center, and conveyance system upgrades. Work will begin this year on these projects. It will begin this year. Together, this system will protect the Strait of Juan de Fuca and ensure that treated wastewater will meet national standards under our new federal wastewater systems effluent regulations. Funding for these projects will come from the Government of Canada's Economic Action Plan and the Building Canada Fund, and the P3 Canada will invest in the Biosolids Energy Centre. Public-private partnerships are an innovative solution to our long-term infrastructure needs. Our government encourages proponents of major infrastructure projects to explore P3 funding options to ensure the best value for taxpayers, affordability and sustainability over the long term are indeed key. And P3 projects ensure on-budget, on-time delivery of public infrastructure by leveraging the expertise of the private sector towards the public benefit. Projects like the Biosolids Energy Centre show how governments and the private sector can work together to provide innovative solutions to the construction and operation of critical infrastructure. Our government is proud to support the Capital Regional District's projects. By investing in this important initiative, we are following through on our commitments. In 2006, we have worked together with the provinces and territories and municipalities all across the country and delivered significant investments to improve infrastructure across the country. And in fact, the province of British Columbia is receiving more money for infrastructure projects than any time before in Canada's history. And from coast to coast to coast, communities like Victoria and Saanich, Oak Bay, Esquimalt, Langford, and West Shore are experiencing the benefits of our infrastructure investments. Here in British Columbia, we have seen more dollars put forward to these projects than ever before, and we will continue on this path right across the country because it's one of the best ways to create local jobs and to help local communities remain among the best places in the world to live, to work, and to raise a family. As we gather here today, rest assured that our government remains focused on creating the right conditions for economic growth and long-term prosperity for all Canadians. That includes predictable long-term funding to help municipalities address their infrastructure needs, and also to make sure that the priorities of local communities are understood in Ottawa, not projects that are designed in Ottawa and forced onto municipalities, but listening to Victoria, listening to the CRD, listening to British Columbia, and taking those ideas to Ottawa and coming back with results, results like we're going to see with the project that we're funding here today. So I want to thank all of you very much for your patience and for being here. I know this is something that has been thought about and talked about and debated and theorized over for a very long time, but construction is beginning soon. Work begins this year. The funding is now flowing, and the partnership has been built. And this investment from the federal government of over $250 million to end the dumping of raw sewage into the waters around Victoria, its time has come, and we're taking action. I want to thank all of you for your partnerships and for making sure that this good project will move forward. Thank you all very much.